In the little city of Delft in the Netherlands, an incredibly famous art form was refined, ceramics. These ceramics are made from three types of clay and shaped into several different usable and decorative pieces, from vases to bowls to tiles and to plates. It is most famous for its white background and cobalt blue designs and shiny smooth surface. The original creators of white and blue ceramics like this were in Asia, mainly in China and Japan, and their pure white clay, called porcelain, allowed for beautiful pure colors and fired to a very shiny finish. Europeans loved Chinese porcelain because it was all hand-painted by artists who paid very close attention to detail. When the Chinese Wanli Emperor died in 1620, Chinese porcelain was very difficult to get a hold of anymore, so in stepped the potters of the Netherlands. Porcelain isn't available in Europe, so the Dutch had to figure out a way to get the same effect. Through trial and error, they discovered that they could mix three types of clay, add a glaze, heat it in a special oven called a kiln, then hand paint it with cobalt blue, then cover it in a lead glaze and put it back in the kiln, and the end product would look just like porcelain. Although it wasn't porcelain, they preferred for it to be called porcelain. Delft pottery, or Delftware, became the European replacement for Chinese porcelain. It became so popular that Delft potters turned their six beer factories into ceramic factories to keep up with demand. If you look at the back of Delft pottery, you'll see the stamp from the factory it was created in, and it will still be named after the beer that was made there originally. Delftware was originally made to copy Chinese porcelain and so uses stylized flowers and birds, especially the peacock, because the peacock was used a lot in Chinese work. However, Dutch artists soon developed a style of their own, making Delftware distinct from porcelains and other copycats from other countries. Delftware is renowned for its beautiful Dutch scenes like windmills and boats and an ocean or canals. It is also known for having symmetrical and intricate borders and stylized flowers. For your outer border, you will need either one design that goes all the way around the plate, or you will need two designs. Either way, imagine your plate like the face of a clock. Whatever design you place at the top, which is where the number 12 is, you'll draw the same thing across from it, so number 6, and the same for 9 and 3, and so on, like this. If you're doing two designs, fill in the gaps in between with the second design, like this. I'm going to draw stylized flowers.